Hello, everyone. Welcome to MindBody TV. I'm Dr. Kim Duramo. I'm going to be sharing today about how to follow your heart. How to follow your heart for guidance in health, work, and love. And I'm really excited to be sharing this because, I mean, I'm always really excited for these broadcasts. I share from my heart. Yes, guidance comes through. And there's a process to that we can learn for how to be in that alignment that allows us to express from the heart, which is our truth, which is our highest expression, and which comes from a space bigger than our small self, bigger than the mind. Hello, everyone who's joining here live. Hi, Rita. I'd love to hear where people are tuning in from and to hear, you know, whatever's coming up as you're listening and what resonates for you as we go. And even if you're listening to the recording, I get those comments as well. So definitely pipe in and share. Hi, Julie from Iowa. Cool. So for those of you who were here last week, we did this broadcast. It got lost. It didn't get put up to Facebook for some reason. It was a really good broadcast. It was rich. The questions were amazing. And I felt really bummed after, like, ah. And so that, like, attachment can make us really uncomfortable and can bring up like a heaviness, right? Because we gotta be in the moment of what is. There was nothing we could do to recoup it. But sometimes there's like that lingering attachment where we wish we could, we wish it was different, and we hold that. And it's one example of like when our energy is in anywhere other than the now, there will be contraction in the body. It feels bad. It will feel heavy. It'll feel, oh, this like heavy feeling. And, you know, if you're conscious and aware, you bring yourself back. And the instant elevation tool or the program, if you go in a more advanced exercise with it, is exactly to do that. How do I bring myself back to this moment where I am now so that that can release? Usually emotions are meant to be held just for a few seconds. We're not meant to like stew in it over and over and over. So anyway, I wanted to share that experience because I could feel that coming up and it was like, embrace what is as it is. So my intention is that this broadcast is even more awesome and more expansive and more grounded and speaks to you even more powerfully, because I'm going to share the topic we did last week about how to follow your heart for guidance in health, wealth, and love. And the science behind that, of what's going on neurologically when we listen to our heart, when we follow our heart, when we tune in and open and receive guidance, versus when we're in our mind. How are these different? How do you know the difference? And what's going on neurologically and in our body or electromagnetically that allows this to happen? Where does this wisdom come from? What's going on? And, you know, this does go beyond the mind for various reasons. And I'm going to share some of the medicine and science behind that. Hello, Vanessa. Michelle, tension in the shoulders and the jaw. Mandy, a live woman from Saskatchewan. That is pretty cool. Saskatchewan, Canada. Hi, Liam from New York. Rachel from UK. Irina from Belgium. Amanda from the North Shore. I grew up in the North Shore, Boston. Brad. Hi, Brad and Pamela. Oh my gosh, so good to see you guys. Susan, Cassie. All right, Lydia. We got a bunch of people who all joined. So welcome, Texas, Michelle. All right, everyone. So Mirka from Czech Republic. All right, so we've got a worldwide clan here live. And I want to talk a little bit about what's going on in the heart. When we talk about follow your heart, a lot of people have the awareness of that. Like, yeah, follow your heart, la, la, la. Hey, but what really matters, we got to buckle in. I can't trust my heart. I got to make sure I'm doing the right thing here. And I'm going to share with you why it is essential and it is the wisest thing you can possibly do to tune into your heart for absolutely everything, every choice, every decision, every moment, so that you begin to live more from this expansive space. What happens, and for those of you who don't know me, I am a physician. I was board certified in emergency medicine, but am very highly intuitive, can read people's bodies, exactly what's going on energetically that's at the cause of their pain or their illness or their struggles, and assist you in unwinding that, releasing that, so that you're in clarity and in fluidity. So when we tune into the heart, there's actually what we found scientifically, neurons around the area of your heart that are sensory neurons. They pick up information, they pick up awareness, different from the neurons in the brain, but they actually function independently. So we have these neurons in the tissue around the heart that pick up awareness and information. Yes, we have the neurons in the brain that register memories, thoughts, beliefs, judgments, assumptions, history, paying attention like a sponge to everything going on throughout our life. And we have a lot of patterns in place for how that plays out, what we think, you know, we think we are, what we think the body is about, what we think is possible. All right, I'm going to just pause for a second. There's a diagram that I showed last week, and I want to use the pens that I had, so I gotta get those. All right, so in this area, it actually functions on its own, separate from the brain, and the neurologic function in this area around the heart sends signals to every area of our body. Meaning it can repattern what's happening in the brain. It can send new signals to your kidneys, to your gut, to your liver, to your reproductive organs, giving it a higher frequency information, actually allowing a patterning, a realignment, and healing. When we tune into the heart, and all you've got to do is either just put your hand on your heart, feel and sense the area around your heart, breathe in your heart, or feel a sense of love. Feel a sense of all is well. I accept myself fully. It's okay to be exactly where I am right now. And to breathe through that. When we do this, it lights this. We get new information in this area. It's like turning up the volume on the receptivity that's happening here. And it will automatically send new information to your body. So one of the things I've done in work as a mind-body doctor, people understand that our beliefs and our thoughts will affect our physical body. And we have tons of science demonstrating how that works with neurotransmitters, with hormones, with other chemical signals that these cells are picking up on. But we also have those patterns get like locked in place. So it's like the brain is replaying and replaying and replaying over and over this location. And since our body is a receptor, we're going to register that. So like, for example, I was working with a client who had really, really severe anxiety. She felt guilt over what was going on with her sons because she's kind of always, you know, reading or in therapy. Doing stuff for herself just to manage her anxiety. And she's like, I really haven't been there for them. I feel guilty. I haven't been a good mother. All of this, I'm not good enough. So if you think of patterns in the brain, they're going to pick up on that information. Now, it may have nothing to do with you're not being good enough, but it's getting interpreted through that filter and the neurons that fire together, wire together, and those patterns get ingrained. So then something happens. Someone says something. Someone does something. You lose your job. Your child says something. And you're like, oh, all that guilt of what an inadequate person I am and what an inadequate mother I've been, get triggered. And how it goes is you end up seeing everything through that filter, and everything becomes a reflection and a validation that's true. Meanwhile, we are neuroplastic. We can let those uncouple, change the wiring that's happening, and we begin to perceive something completely different. Is what happened with my client when she came into a new frequency. And I'm going to talk about that in a moment, why this happened. We come into a space of I love and accept myself fully. Why this happens when we come into a higher frequency, what's going on at the heart, what's going on in the brain. She began to realize the reason I'm so empathic and sensitive and experiencing all this anxiety is because I'm aware, and I'm here to shift this pattern for myself, for my family, for my sons, who I love more than anything. And becoming more conscious is the greatest service of love I can do for them. So even if society says I haven't been there for them in this way, or my mind says I should be doing this and I'm not, what's actually happening? What's the truth? She's a warrior of the heart to shift the patterns of her lineage of anger, shame, and fear that automatically get passed down to her son if they're not transmuted, which is what she's actually been up to in her own body. Very different perspective, but we won't be able to even comprehend that when we're in those lower frequencies of fear or shame. So hang on one sec. Just want to see if we can get my pen. All right, because I had a good diagram I drew last week, and it was really helpful. So basically, this information comes in our brain when we're putting a lot of energy in the brain and attention in the brain and asking questions, what's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? We're not accessing our wisdom. The brain is a dualistic organ. There's a left and right hemisphere. There's a right and a wrong, a good and a bad, a superior and an inferior. How should I do this? So if you're asking questions from your mind, it will always be limited because it's based on the judgments and the conclusions and the beliefs, which have all been part of that pattern and programming. The heart is non-dualistic. The heart, there's a single heart. It's in the space, not of what you believe, but of what you know. And so when you ask a question, you resonate in the heart. You can ask a question like, what else is possible here? What else is possible that I haven't even considered? Or you get information and it feels like, oh, right? I got information about a diagnosis when I had this autoimmune condition. Here's what you've got. Here's what you got to do. Here's all the badness. Here's how you got to rearrange your life. This is going to affect you forever. Here's the medication you need. And it felt so heavy and helpless. And then I realized, wait a minute, is this true for me? I asked a different question. For months and months and months, over a year, I was asking, what's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? You're going to immediately channel into the mind and trigger into all those beliefs, assumptions, and judgments. One simple question, one simple shift brought me into a higher frequency of awareness. Your heart registers higher frequency information. But it, you know, what's true for me? Is this true for me? And I immediately felt, Kim, let this go. This is not your truth. You don't need to follow that path. This is not what's true for you. This is not your solution. So I'm gonna look into some of these comments. And the question last week is, how do I know the difference between my heart and my brain? Especially because we exercise so much into the brain patterns, which are all based in fear and control. And control is like the flip side of it. So the brain is, you know, those patterns are there to protect you because you think you're separate, you're powerless, you're not safe, you're not okay. You need to do more. You need to keep going. You need to try harder. And it will show you a world where that's all true. Wow, I really do need to push myself really hard or I'll lose my job. I really do need to, you know, scrimp and save or I won't have enough money. Your life is going to be the reflection of whatever consciousness you're in. But how does this affect your body? Okay, let's look at some of these questions. Alyssa, I've had endometriosis. Can this be healed? Tried to meditate and let it go, but I don't feel I'm holding on to it. I feel like I'm holding on to it. In a moment. Yes, you know me. Oh, okay. Cool. Okay, Cheryl, hello. Victoria from Arizona. Andy! Hey, could you do me a favor? Hang on one sec. Could you go to my office and get, you can open it. Get the Sharpies. There's a blue one, like turquoise, and a red one. Thanks. Hold on a sec. Oh, good. I love doing that. Alex says, is the difference between the heart and the brain the same as the difference between fear and intuition? I struggle with convincing myself that fear is actually a gut feeling of intuition. It's me into a lot of trouble. This is something that came up last week, so I want to talk a lot about that. So when we're in that duality of the brain, it's a lot of fear responses. You shouldn't do this. You can't do that. Watch out for this. Make sure about that. Well, that energy gets channeled, that consciousness of fear, because we are a giant receptor from an electromagnetic standpoint. We are pure energy. The message that gets sent cellularly, that's the message transmitting. Yep, just open it. Really? Hold on one sec, everybody.
He must have locked it from inside. Thank you. Okay, sorry about that.
So as I was saying, because we are a giant electromagnetic like antenna, bringing in information in every moment, we're bringing in consciousness. And we've seen energy centers of the body, this information gets deciphered and distributed. So you've got the crown chakra, the third eye chakra, the throat chakra, all the way down to your second chakra with reproductive organs, your first chakra that affects your whole lower body. Well, we've seen medically, and there are incredible doctors. One of my mentors, Jan Northrup, looked a lot at how this affects our reproduction. She deals with women's medicine and how the thoughts, beliefs, ideas create a transmission at these levels, affect our organs. So a lot of people with thyroid problems, thyroid disease, look at your throat chakra, what's going on. Am I free to express my truth? Am I opening the chakra and allowing the deepest expression of myself I know? Or am I in the brain with patterns of belief, assumption, judgment, and ideas, and I'm living according to that? That's actually going to feed the cells of my thyroid, the cells of everything in this area. Reproductively, we've seen huge amounts of medical studies that are showing, you know, when there's fear, when there's anger, when there's betrayal, we clamp down our energy at these levels, and then the cells are starving. So when we're looking at the heart versus the brain, we're either on a pattern in a program, which is what's stored in mind, triggers fight or flight, triggers our fear response. It's protective. That is not meant physiologically to be beyond a few moments. We're not meant to live in a chronic response. So how do we begin instead to know what's the difference? The heart will never communicate in fear. It will only communicate in truth. So for example, let's say, you know, hey, that's a bad idea, right? I'm gonna go start this business thing, or I'm gonna date that person, or I'm gonna take that supplement, okay? And your body's like, right? It can give you a no, but it doesn't need to be in fear. It can come through awareness. So a really powerful way to tune in here, and I'm going to give you this experience with this exercise so that you begin to understand what I mean, what the difference is between fear and awareness, no. So the first step in this process is to tap on or touch your hand, the area over your heart. When you touch this area, it actually activates sensory awareness. It activates those sensory neurites, those sensory receptors, to heighten your awareness of what's coming in at this level. So just physically touching is enough, or gently tapping over that area. Then you want to take 3 to 5 breaths, slower and deeper than your usual breath. In through nose, out through the mouth is fine. What this does, you might feel a yawn. Sometimes people feel tears when they begin letting energy move. You might just feel relaxation. So with these 3 to 5 breaths, relax shoulders. And see if you can just relax everything and let the breath come in belly. This turns off the fight or flight patterns in the brain. So you're not running from the tiger right now. You can come into that parasympathetic response, which is a healing restorative response. to allow a shift out of mind functioning into heart functioning. If you're in the mind, spinning the wheels, you can't hear your wisdom. So you've got to do this little piece to like, let's turn it off. Let's close that down. Let's just relax around that. Turning off fight or flight, it decreases your cortisol levels, your stress hormone. It increases hormones, oxytocin and endorphins that help you connect with love, with awareness, with serenity. So there's an immediate chemical shift, but there's also a major neurologic patterning. We've seen scientifically that the size of the amygdala, which is like alert, stress, decrease with this kind of practice. So there's less, your body's less in trigger, danger. Everything being registered as a threat as you practice awareness. So 3 to 5 breaths to slow and deepen your breath. Relax your shoulders. That's enough to turn off fight or flight so that you can begin to feel and sense. Without that step, it's like almost possible to decipher my heart, what's my mind? Because from that frequency of fear, you don't have that awareness. Okay, and then the third step is you ask a question. So if you're wanting guidance around a specific choice or a specific action or something that's coming up for you and you're certain, you can simply ask, is this the highest possibility for me? Will this contribute to my well-being? So the second step, so you touch your heart, second step is breathing, just relax your body. You'll begin to feel a little bit lighter. That lightness is the frequency of your heart. So now when you ask the question, you can try that right now. You'll feel the difference between beating up of, you should do this, you should do that. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. The whisper, sometimes it's a subtle whisper of the surrender of the heart. Is this in my highest and best? Will this contribute to my well-being? When we're in the brain, what's wrong with me? What should I do? That's a different channel. It's a different awareness. You're actually accessing and turning on and lighting up a different kind of information, one that is not going to serve you. So I tell people, like, when you're in fear, because people will say, like, wait, what is this reliable? Like, when it really matters, I have cancer, I could die, or this is a major investment for me. It's even more important. Because you want to be functioning from program, or do you want to be functioning from truth? So you've got to tune in. And so I always tell people when they're thinking of working with me or coming into programs or coming to a retreat, feel it out for yourself. You are the world expert on what is the highest best for you, whether it's your diet and how you eat or picking a partner or your day-to-day activities or an investment you're going to make. You within you, that wisdom within you is the world expert on everything. And so connect with yourself, feel this. What do I know? And am I willing to choose what I know? Maybe I'm still too scared. Maybe I need more clarity. Okay. It's okay. But at least tune in, touch your heart, breathe and slow down. And then ask the question, what is the highest available to me? What would it take for me to heal completely and fully? What would it take for me to live fully? What would it take for me to live in joy? What would it take for me to have to welcome the wealth I know is available? Well, take to welcome the opportunities. I have someone using my work and bought the MindBody Toolkit, the book, and said, and she also used the Instant Elevation Tool. She said that she had had chronic severe Lyme disease and told me this completely was a revolutionary change. And even in this pandemic, I'm offered this new job and all these opportunities have come. So the mind will say, well, you can't have that because, you know, the world will go down and nothing's happening, the economy's dropping, and so it's going to affect you negatively. But if you ask your heart, it's possible here. Is that true for me? What else is possible? I guarantee you something else comes in. You may not at first consciously register it, and that's fine. Practice. Slow down, doesn't feel. Because sensing what the awareness is from your heart is more about sensing and feeling and witnessing and less about grasping and I have to know and what is it? I don't know. And you're gonna have like a certainty. So if it just comes in, the heart really often communicates just through pure energy. So you feel a sense of lightness. So I'll tell people like, okay, here's the, you know, if we're gonna work together, you're gonna come to an event, how does this resonate? Does it feel heavy or light? Ah, it feels light. Yes. Okay, then just keep opening. Let the resources come in. Keep meeting whatever is here for you. And the path reveal itself. So sometimes it's just the energy. But very often when we keep tuning in that, we will decipher and decode that and actually have like a real clarity. Kim, do this. Or let that go. And for me, that all the time, every day. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the energy body and how this works and how it moves through. So let's say here's your body and here's conscious coming through. Okay. So you have, I hope that shows up. Yeah. Okay. So you have whatever consciousness. Let's call it the belief systems, the programs you grew with, right? They're all at the same frequency. So whether it's, I'll never make enough money, I'm not good enough, or whether it's, I deserve to have abundance and health, whether it's, I have to really, really hard improve myself, or whether it's worthy of love, right? You'll feel, you might not hear them, but you'll feel that. Same thing. And what it creates in the body, you know, because this comes down to all the energy centers throughout our body and it feeds and fuels our body. So this is information coming in through our system. We're either on the joy love channel or we're on the doom channel. I mean, there's lots of channels in between. It's a continuum. And I have a lot of videos on YouTube where I've shared about this. It's a continuum. But let's just make it extreme so we can see the difference. When I'm on the doom and gloom channel, this literally creates heaviness, toxicity in my body. And likewise, my body is the receptor either for the joy channel or the doom and gloom channel. Okay? So when I get on joy love channel, so I have a blue pen, and last week I realized like it's the blue pill versus the red pill. So if you've seen The Matrix, there's a lot of really metaphors in that. We get in the blue channel. The blue channel is, I am worthy of love. I am love. I simply show up, breathe, and receive. My body can heal all by itself when I allow. I am whole and complete in the power of my own inner knowing. Okay, these are all the frequencies, if you were to decipher them and put them into like a thought idea, that's what's on the joy love channel. It's just pure energy, but that's what it would sound like. Okay, now when you channel this in, and there's many ways to do that, just the tool I showed you, touch your heart, slow your breathing, relax and soften, will allow this to come in. Now, it's already here, right? What's on the joy love channel? Solutions to all the problems I could possibly have. Now, the problem and the solution do not exist on the same frequency. This is really important to understand. We are giant receptors. We must shift frequency in order to let those things dissolve and resolve. What most people are doing is staying on the same frequency, but throwing more drugs at it, or having surgery, or 25 supplements, or a new diet, or I've got to see another practitioner, I've got to do this and I've got to do that. And you may get temporary relief, but you're not actually getting a quantum shift. You're not actually resolving what's happening. So you got to keep fighting and fighting. If you create even 2% shift in frequency, to open to something higher. And I'll put a little caveat. The surest way to do that is by embracing where you are. Not get on another channel. I gotta get there. Shortest way to do that, 2% opening or even bigger opening, is to embrace where you are. That's enough. It allows new information to come in. And this is the important part. This not only feeds your cells, your brain, because it does. We are neuroplastic. It repatterns those pathways in your brain. You don't have to go to a lobotomy or practice beliefs and affirmations over and over. That's functioning here on the same frequency. It will repattern what's happening throughout your system. This is why I'm doing the work the way I'm doing it. And I don't use a lot of supplements or even like homeopathy or other stuff. Those are beautiful things. But when we shift our alignment, this is what I found the most powerful. To feed your cells and shift what's happening in the body, which we've seen can happen instantly. But also because we are energy receptors, we're a transmitter. We are transmitting information and intelligence and messages, so to speak. And functions. I got about this a lot more in the Embracing Health program. We are a receptor, we are a transmitter, and we are transmuters. We actually come back into its purest form. So let's just talk about that transmission. Is your transmission, oh, I really suck. Don't pay me a lot of money. Don't love me. Don't treat me well. Don't listen to what I'm saying. Betray me, abandon me, abuse me, right? Because we're resonating on the frequency of the victim. And do make yourself wrong for this, because there's nothing wrong about this. Because a lot of times when we hear that, it's like, what do you mean? I've worked so hard. I don't deserve that. We receive the channel we're on. Life will be a reflection of this transmission. It's like we're projecting onto the giant screen of life. And when we connect here with the frequency of the heart, it gets us on the joy love channel. That's where people say, oh, I feel love, and they touch themselves here. This is a power center. We can get on the joy love channel and allow a whole new awareness to come in by this powerful process. It repatterns your neurology, it repatterns your entire, all the hard wiring in your body physically. The physical cells change, your DNA changes. To me, it's kind of unthinkable that we have this awareness scientifically, but we're still functioning in conventional medicine as if, you know, the physical is all there is. That's all there is to your body, and it's a static, solid thing. It's all there is to your body, and you have this disease, and therefore, right? Problem, solution, trying to find a solution at the same frequency. Well, what if we can shift and allow new information to come in through the body? It emits a new signal throughout our body, and I've seen your immune system is strong, and you no longer have Epstein-Barr virus. You no longer have Lyme disease. You no longer have fibromyalgia. You no longer have thyroid disease. The thyroid can resolve and restore. Now, this is not a universal thing, but for most people, that is the truth of what's going on and what's possible. Only you know for yourself. Is this true for me? The higher possibility? And if it feels right, that's a yes. So, and when I say it's not universal, what I'm saying is illness is not like a wrongness. There's a functionality sometimes to like the function of your legs and going through life in a particular way, or having a different neurologic pattern going through life in that way. What are you integrating through that? It can be functional. For most of us though, these chronic illnesses that so many people are living with are a function of the frequency you are on, not a universal love true for your body. So this emission is different. I'm amazing. I'm beautiful. Look at me. Radiate. And the more you relax your body, the more that emission comes. People can see you And I receive all of the time that people will bump into me who've never met me before and be like, I know you. Who are you? Or we'll have a conversation. And it's like the deep level of conversation they've ever had. And they're like, I've never told anyone that. I feel like I know you. What is that? I know you because we are connected in unity. And this universal truth, your essence comes through. People can see you. People can feel you. They know you. Knowing here. This is believing. And the brain is believing. And the heart, it's knowing. But if you're showing up in your heart, you're just a talking head. And people have to get all kinds of information to feel like they know you, right? Where you're from, how old are, how many kids you have, what do you do for a living, who are you married to, what do you do for fun? But are any of those things really you? What's the real you? The real you is this. This emanation through the heart, this. Okay, so this is an important piece because this, for so many people I work with, will experience this. And they'll say, well, I don't know if my symptoms are better yet, but everything in my life changed. And yeah, I'm starting to feel it in my body. And then maybe it's eventually like there's a shift on the physical level in their cells. Sometimes it's the opposite. Sometimes the cellular change happens first. Doesn't matter. It matters that you tune in to this new change. So we have a lot of us to understand this. We understand that we are electromagnetic beings. We are pure vibration. How do we get on this higher channel? And that's really what all of my work has been. And even if you do is presence where you are right now, that opens enough. Vanessa said, I love this. I'm receiving this in a completely different way. It's so powerful. Chris, you're ahead of your time, Dr. Kim. The medical field will catch up with your teaching when people can accept it. The community will come to terms with the fact that we've been treating chronic illness the wrong way. Yeah, I've known that for a long time too. I'm really cool now, and it's happening. We can see evidence of it every day. I think this pandemic is bringing people into an awareness of like, what's going on here? Thank you. I said when I did this just now, I felt afraid to get an answer I didn't want. But let's talk about that for a minute, because it happens a lot that the mind has this conclusion. Well, I can't leave my job. I can't leave my husband. And like my heart's gonna ask me this thing that's gonna actually create something bad. So just back up, if this is eternal wisdom of infinity and the highest version of you, because we are connected to that divinity, that infinite intelligence. You can think of it as spirit or God or whatever works for you. If we're connected to that, maybe some of our assumptions and beliefs about what that would look like are not, we can let them go, right? Like, but if I left my job, I'd have no money and it wouldn't be. So I hope my heart's not asking me to do that because, hey, heart, I know you have all this infinite wisdom, but when it comes to this, I'm just going to kind of manage this one myself because I know about that. So it's really a surrender to allow just a little realization in some of the assumptions and ideas that we've held, because that will just block you from receiving something. Heather, is there a number to this frequency? I notice on YouTube they have some frequencies one can listen to. All the Ophidio frequencies, they are all on the harmonic channel, the harmonic space. So there's different hertz, different frequencies that we've seen. The physical cells vibrate a certain way, resonate a certain way. It resonates in your body, even in your day, when we listen to these sound frequencies. So just like, you know, we're talking here, the frequencies are already here. Like the solutions to every problem you can conceive of is already here, just like a radio channel. But what frequency am I dialing into? Well, the social frequencies are not really in different consciousness, that they're just subtle different ways resonates energies in the cells. Deborah, during this pandemic, I cannot go to my neurochiropractor for treatment for a severe vestibular neuritis. Can this work to resolve this? Even with poor prognosis, I refuse to adopt that mindset. Sounds like it can. Yes, of course it can. So you gotta feel that for yourself. Like, okay, if my body is pure energy and there's patterns in place structurally, like even if you just come I'm in space of I'm limited, I'll never make it, or I'm unworthy, I'll never make it. Right? That's the frequency. You'll feel a physical tension in your when you just soften around that a little, which puts you on a different channel, your body can dissolve a lot. Without going like too much further into what happens on the quantum level, we've seen truly remarkable things happen with a diseased cell all of a sudden expressing complete health. So see what, and there may be particular things or a person or a treatment that can be that process for you. But when you're on, you know, the frequency of the problem, you won't access them. You keep running around seeing more people who fix the problem, but it's temporary and it comes back. You've got to get on the frequency of the solution to welcome in and access, like the person who could do it, or the money to go, or the time, or, you know, all of it is part of that equation. Catching the heart, Lily, be lying down. If someone has trust, yes. Justin, when I meditate, I get an answer that I'm experiencing an awakening, spiritual and kundalini. And the purge from is causing some markers from blood draws to rise. Those answers bring me peace. Yeah, you can trust 100%. You'll see what else is possible here. What's important to me. There are things to do. Maybe just, Kim, just stay tuned. Instructions, you're good. Go about your day. There's not necessarily a lot to do. Michael said, you got COVID. Oh, in nuts. On nuts? Unit. You got the COVID unit listening in the Jersey Shore. No fear. Hi. And I have clarity today to let go and use my art as my tool to express and receive everything I need. Which is awesome. So a lot of this awareness could be really simple. Could be something that's already in your life, but because you've got this conclusion about it, you're like, oh no, it couldn't be that. I can't. Let's just, you know, that's just a hobby. And what wants to open in your life may look so different from what your beliefs are. That's why I'm saying, like, let it seep in. Get curious. That will also soften the brain patterns. All right, what else I want to share? I had somebody send me from what I shared last week. Thank you, beautiful Nora. And because I wanted to kind of touch on some of the same topics. So there's the tool. Here's the thing. This is really helpful to remember. Oh, where am I? This harmonic, when we access the frequency heart, you've got to slow down, allow some softening and relaxation to begin to connect. Does the recalibration for you. That's why I learned in osteopathic school, the body heals itself. And then when I went on and developed this chronic autoimmune illness, like, I've got to heal myself. No, you don't heal yourself. It's actually a completely different thing. You open to allow the conditions that where self-healing can occur. For those of you who would like to go deeper, we are opening up a new group to start in Embracing Health. It's a year-long integration where we do call monthly, and I'll assist you, answer more questions, get more in depth. And you know, there's a lot of integration done around this with groups of people where it's that higher harmonic coming in that is, you know, on that higher channel to allow your system to open and receive. Like, that's kind of your job. But it's not your job to heal yourself. So the link, drkimd.com/health, if you're interested in joining that program starting in June for the next group starting. So this recalibration is really the most powerful part. That's why I really dedicated back to what assists this. I've read for years and decades about spontaneous healing, you know, self-healing. Really powerful things now understandably. So it was like, I'm not gonna mess around with anything else. That's what I wanna learn, how to activate that. How do we access that? How do we reliably allow that to happen instead of this spontaneous thing? Hey, it's spontaneous remission, so we're gonna leave it, stand it. No, that's I want to study only that. I want to learn how that and how we can influence that and how we can reliably welcome that. That's what I've done. Is the difference between, yes. Yeah, so fear and intuition, getting back to Al's question, fear will block intuition, because when you're in fear, you clamp down, you go into fight, right? You get into the channel of the brain, you shut off, you know, you're kind of like suppressing this awareness. Intuition, which is embedded throughout the body, there's all the neural networks throughout the gut, which is a brain in and of itself, secreting its own neurotransmitters, communicating with the whole body, with the immune system, with your nervous system, that functions on its own. And there's different kind of information we access there. You get like, I have a gut feeling, or I feel it down to my balls, right? If for masculine, you know that you have wisdom integrated throughout your body. And this kind of what we're talking about, that we access at the heart, is that highest frequency of and knowing. It's not a thinking, it's not a judgment. All right. Oh shoot, is it choppy? Somebody said that the broadcast is choppy. Oh, sorry about that. You suggest a certain number of times to practice this breathing if it's on the heart. Practice it until it's more and more integrated. So it might be 3 times a day. To just tune in more and more. And then you can use as needed, like when there's a challenge, when there's something coming up. But set your alarm now to practice it 3 times a day, because you might just like forget. You're here right now. We're at a certain frequency. You're like, this makes sense. Then you leave and go into your life. You're like, oh, whatever, that airy fairy stuff. I got to deal with the real world now. And you're on a different channel. So set your alarm to bring you back and integrate them more and more. So getting down to Alyssa, how can I heal this endometriosis? And that has a lot to do with your relationship with your womanhood, being a sensing, intuitive being, to express your wisdom, to let it come through, to stand and know what you know, and allow yourself to share that and be that instead of whistling it and holding it in. There, and it could be much deeper of what delving into this work a little further. And if there's a program that, you know, if you want to work together, or the health program where we're in a group, there may be something for you to really look at this and receive this and let it open you up to a much, much deeper experience of who you are. It's the teaching of Abraham Hicks. Well, yes, there's on the frequency of letting yourself know what you know. I'm just more plugging into like the medicine and the science and the physical anatomy of it, and relating to healing, because creation, you know, we're co-creator. I've got to manifest this. I've got to manifest health. We can only allow the circumstances for that to come through us. Liam says, it takes off so much pressure and blame knowing I can't force myself to heal myself. I can't force anything to come into your creation. Stop making it wrong, because like I said in the beginning, the surest way to open up to the blue channel is the red channel, exactly where you are now. And then you let this come in. It recalibrates throughout your entire system. Yes, this can happen very quickly, but don't require it to be an instant thing. Just settle in for whatever that looks like for you. And then, yes, this is your new emission, a new signal, a new emanation. People will see it. They hear it in your voice. Tonality is different. Every atom is communicating this new signal. So it's a lot less work to try to like, I gotta manifest my life. All right. We feel fear in my gut. Yeah, we can feel it. So when I have a gut feeling, I think it's just me being scared. When you clear fear, you're gonna let yourself register different information through your body. So there are a lot of, you know, tools and things that I've used, but just breathe into where you feel that fear and keep your hand on your heart and relax, and it will allow a lot of that transmutation to happen. Breathe a quick, slow release through the mouth. So slowly in, slowly out. be in through the nose, out through the nose, in through the nose, out through the mouth. That is the most important part. Mm-hmm. Leslie says, my dog was having trouble walking and the first vet was on the frequency of she's old and on the way out. Second vet was better. But in this discussion, I'm realizing that I'm being, I've been helping my dog from the frequency of fear and she's seriously ill. Now I'm thinking about what if she could be on the frequency of okayness and good quality of life, even as she goes through with these challenges. I actually created a, we actually have it probably up now. It's for Lisa Song's program. She's a pediatrician. So a lot of people, yes, parenting from fear instead of love with your dog, with your kids. I created a great video on this and how to really shift the fear you're in so that you can parent from love. And that's available at drkimd.com/EFT kids. There's an EFT practice, a freedom technique for kids and anxiety. And there's this other video about getting out of fear so that you can parent from love. Because I see it so, because of course it brings up fear like nothing else. This dog that you love so much or this challenge. And when you see them struggling, you want to control it. So everyone, thank you for your comments. Thank you for joining. I'll be here every at 11 a.m. Mountain Time on Wednesdays in the MindBody community and Facebook. YouTube, definitely. And you can click the bell. I will be sharing YouTube, so we'll be posting these, and I share a lot of other videos in YouTube as well. If you want to subscribe, I'm at drkimd.com. There's a quiz where it can help you get some really specific tools for this recalibration in yourself right now, whether you're experiencing single illness or anxiety, depression, or you're having other challenges that are coming up and you know this is part of your awakening process. That's my lots of love to you. I hope it was well received. Thing and you're like, oh, it didn't go as expected. And I've welcomed this as another experience. Like, you wouldn't think that big a deal. It's just sometimes it's surprising what the trigger could be. And another layer where to release of any lack that basically is just energy as we come to joy. Love chat. We get off the fear channel. With that frequency, I am infinite being, but the fear channel is physical person. I am this, 47-year-old woman, and I am, limited perspective. We can tell as physical and limited to reach consciousness. So it's about the consciousness. It's not about the pill. All right, everyone. Lots of love to you. So glad this was useful, and I'll see you very soon.